Jeff Hart is running for parish president, of course. The parish councilman joins us here at Keep Livingston Beautiful. What a great meeting. And a lot of these folks, you know, they're volunteers. And what could parish government do without the volunteers that help?
Oh, absolutely. We need volunteers to help us clean our parish up. We've had some good organizations in here lately. We've had a river cleanup. We've got this group right here that's helping us organize stuff on the weekends. And, man, it's really helping us beautify our parish.
In the meantime, turmoil back at the parish council, including a conversation over whether or not the zoning we've already implemented needs to be rescinded, which took everybody, I think, by surprise, with the mood of the people to want to slow down a bit. What do you think?
I really don't feel like we need to rescind what's already been put in place. I think we might need to pause and have a moratorium so that we can implement the whole parish. You know, it's been 5 months. We have some councilmen that I feel like are dragging their feet, and we need our parish zoned. And rescinding, to me, is stepping back, and I'm not for that.
Where do we stand in the subdivision regulations that are on the books? I mean, we don't have a moratorium, for instance.
No, we don't have a moratorium on that. But I think all the regulations are there. They're stricter. We haven't had any subdivisions come forward to build under the new regulations, so we don't really know what problems or kinks to work out yet.
So what do you do to help the people who are concerned about we've just had too much growth? Can you do a moratorium?
We could do a moratorium. I just don't know if that's the answer as far as stopping development right now, because it's like anything that's designed. You need something built the way you designed it to see if what you did is the correct thing. So,
plus, what you've done is greatly increase the minimum lot size.
Yes, we've created that. So it's less lots. They have to reduce the drainage by 20% on the outflow of the development. So a lot of them things we feel like are going to make a major difference. But unfortunately, it's kind of like when you design a car, you need one built to see if it's going to work.
Well, right now, I mean, as you say, no one has even submitted a plan for the new regulations.
No, sir. We haven't had any submitted yet. We do have some that were approved before all the changes that have went back and on their own done at least the drainage reduction of 20%.
So in the meantime, how's your campaign coming?
Campaign's going good. We're out putting signs out everywhere, raising money. We're starting to set up some meet and greets to get around the parish, and hitting every fundraiser I can to just help anywhere as I can with my community.
So there's talk that there'll be a third candidate in the race, which wouldn't surprise anybody. There were only two for all these months.
Yeah, we've been hearing a third guy for a long time. There's a couple of names floating around. But all I can do is focus on me, keep moving forward, and just let the people know that I'm here to do the best I can for them.
What are people telling you as you campaign? What are their concerns about for the next parish president? Because clearly, if Leighton Ricks had decided to run again, he'd have been the clear favorite, might not have even had an opponent.
Yes, I mean, I think one of the things we have to, I can't see anybody not saying drainage is number one. I mean, everybody running should say drainage is number one. Development's probably number two. So we have to figure out a way to bring development in a proper way to where it's not just destroying our parish.
Your opponent has said pretty outspokenly that he thinks there's corruption in parish government. What do you say to that? Do you agree with him?
I don't agree with that. Now I've only been a part of parish government for 8 years. You know, 7.5 actually. I've worked well with the parish president and his administration. I've worked well with this council. I don't always agree with everybody. You know, we all have our own opinions and our own ways of doing things. But I think corruption is a harsh word.
Well, you know, you look at Livingston Parish government since the old police jury days. I mean, look at the progress.
Yes, well, a lot of progress. And the reason that the people voted out the police jury system was they were tired of these police jurymen having all the control in their own district. Now, you can't get 4 votes to go along with your vote. You cannot do anything.
What else do you want to share with us?
I hope everybody get out and support the candidate that you believe in. And if I can do anything for you, just call me. I'm a phone call away.